The Scugog Lake Stewards get a lot of questions about different types of plants in Lake Scugog. So we're going to go through some of the major players of weedy spaghetti in the lake. Milfoil, Latin name Myriophyllum. We have two major kinds in Lake Scugog, the common native species and the Eurasian non-native species.
So this is a fragment of Eurasian milfoil, the non-native type of milfoil. As you can see, these leaflets branch out of the stem in a whorl shape. And if you look closely, each leaf has a number of leaflets. In Eurasian milfoil, it has usually between 9 and 14 leaflets, which is more than the native species of milfoil. You also know it's Eurasian milfoil because of the pink stem, which is more red towards the top.
Milfoil can actually reproduce from fragments, so you can see how it can spread quite rapidly. Coontail, Ceratophyllum demersum. This plant can look a lot like milfoil. The leaves branch off the main stem in a whorl. But unlike milfoil, which divides into many leaflets, coontail only divides one or two times. It's also greener and firmer in texture. Canadian waterweed, Elodia canadensis, is a native species to North America, but it can be considered invasive in other parts of the world. This plant also contains leaves that whirl around the stem that can be bright green and firmer in texture, usually about 3 leaves per whorl. The pond weeds, also known scientifically as podomagetans. There are many different kinds in Lake Scugog, but usually they can have different shapes of leaves, and their larger structure provides excellent habitat for fish. We have large leaf pondweed, which is a native species, but we also have curly leaf pondweed, which is a non-native species. And if you look closely, you can see that the leaf sort of wraps around the stem here, clasping onto the stem. It's also called clasping pondweed. Bladderwort, Utricularia, which is an insectivorous plant, which means it actually eats insects. And it does that with these little bladders, and that's what it uses to capture tiny bugs. Aquatic buttercup, Latin name ranunculus. And I like this Latin name because it sounds like a Harry Potter wizard spell. This little plant can form little yellow or white flowers that pop up above the water column. And below the water, the plant looks a lot like Myriophyllum or milfoil. Water lilies. There are two main kinds, white water lily and yellow water lily. The white being called Nymphaea odorata and the yellow being called Nuphar variegatum. It's easy to tell apart by the color of the flower, but you can also tell them apart by the shape of their leaves. White water lily is more rounded with a sharp V shape cut out of it, whereas yellow water lily is more oval shaped. If you look out at the water and you see a lot of water lilies, you'll find that the water is usually pretty clear. Whereas if you look at a lake that doesn't have a lot of plants and things like water lilies, you might see more algae. This is because water lilies and other plants are really excellent at maintaining good water quality. They also provide good habitat for fish and wildlife. So those are just a few of the amazing plants found in Lake Scugog. There are many more. Ranunculus!